The last one we can do is, this one looks a little funny, but I had a boxer who was a fast switch boxer, a really explosive guy, and every time he transitioned, from side to side to throw his three, he would spin his body, and he would get tremendous pain in his knee because he was locking his knee out. True. We spoke about that earlier. True. So what I tried to teach him was, I said, okay, let's eliminate all of your upper body because he's so strong over here. Right. He's using so much of this. Yeah. I said, okay, eliminate your upper body. Now let's just use your glutes, and he had no glute power. True. That's why he had all that pain in the sciatic nerve. So the load transference exercise that I showed him, the neurocorrective exercise was a bilateral buttock squat like this, a goblet squat, holding a goblet, something strong, a heavy weight, and basically walking with that like that. And then he would jab and throw some hooks from that position. Could you show us that exercise? Yeah. So if you squat down and try to go down all the way to a squat position, and try from this position, he could explode up. So he can actually, he can just push up. Boom, boom, boom. And he's pushing off. He go backwards. This is great for reverse boxing. It looks funny, but you get a nice burn with this one. Keeping your back really, really straight and training this, you would be fantastic. Another way to do it would be sideways too, right? Mm-hmm. So you could actually do these sideways and then walk sideways to create the lateral movement of your hips, to create the gluteus medius muscles, to get them moving, because you'd In boxing, you are transferring load side to side, and you're moving side to side, right? So there you go. Here's a nice little drill for your gluteus maximus for explosive movement.
True.